All right, I think we're recording.
I think we are. I see the numbers going up.
The numbers are going up. And folks, it's We Don't Have a Podcast Yet with Andrew AJ Estes, Nathan B. Woodard, Matthew McConaughey, George Lucas, John Bon Jovi, Bilbo Baggins, Jim Carrey, Fidel Castro, Anne Hathaway, Booker T. Washington, Wolfgang Puck, Ming the Merciless, Kroger Wine and Spirits, Nicolas Cage, The Green Goblin, Hunter S. Thompson, Denzel Washington, Captain Sully Sullenberger, Ulysses S. Grant, James Earl Jones, Coco Chanel, Manny Pacquiao, Microsoft Homepage, Johnny Darko, Maya Angelou, Kevin Garnett, Demi Lovato, Serena Williams, Kenny Chesney, Steve Jobs, The Prophet Mohammed, Dick Wolf, Extension Cord, James Cameron, Frank Serpico, Tina Fey, Mark Harmon, Catherine Hagel, Johnny Jump Up, John the Baptist, David Letterman, Reese Witherspoon, Robert De Niro, Larry the Cable Guy, Larry the Streaming Guy, Larry the HD Radio Guy, Eddie Murphy, Roald Dahl, O.J. Simpson, Socrates, musical guest Dr. Sidney Gottlieb, and your host, Jenner from the Secret of NIMH.
Yay!
I don't know how I got to be first billed in all that. It's
not about who you know, it's about who you blow.
Yeah. And it was everybody on that list.
Folks, we still don't...
I'm glad you got to extension cord. A lot of people forget about extension cord, but there wouldn't be a show without him.
He's done some of the best work. Folks, we still don't have a podcast. As it turns out, we cannot do a podcast where we request that parents send in voicemails of their children talking for us to make fun of. It didn't work out as well as we thought it would.
It did not. But we did learn a lot of new jokes.
We did learn some new jokes.
My joke file is
chock full now. I'm going to listen when this parasite or whatever the virus is over, I'm going to be out there back in the comedy clubs and I'm going to be like, excuse me, waiter, do you have frog legs? No, I have always had ketchup legs made of poop. People will be like, I'm just rubbing that stump at the Showtime at the Apollo. My legs are ketchup and poop. I take over in Bernie Mac's spot in the original Kings of Comedy.
You wear the, like, they give you his suit.
Yeah, I've come out in the big...
It's like the Santa Claus. It's the Bernie Mac Claus.
I'm in like a wine-colored suit with huge shoulder pads. And I'm like, knock, knock, who's there? There's poop on my head. And everyone's like,
they are freaking out.
They're losing their minds. They've never seen anything like it. I don't know. You got anything to say at the top of the show before we get started?
Before we get started, I would just like to say that I too would like to have a wine-colored suit, or maybe a mustard-colored suit, maybe a salmon.
Oh my! These are
suit.
All
there should be more colors of suits available to me.
Those are all perfect colors for Steve Harvey hosting the Family Feud. And before we started, we were talking about Mama's Family. Mama's Family, famously, there was an episode where they were on the Family Feud.
Mama's Family Feud. Wait, who was the host during that era? Did they get the...
I think it was...
the little guy who killed himself?
Well, he went and ruined a bunch of Family Feud for us.
Mm-hmm. Do you think that that episode of Mama's Family holds up, or are you just thinking about it the whole time?
The whole time, I'm like, oh my god, this guy. Oh, is he gonna do it right now?
Yeah, did he do it in the middle of a film?
Survey says...
Names? We asked 100 people to name something they would hate to happen at their taping of Family Feud.
All right, I have an idea for a podcast. This is called A Podcast for All the Haters. And this would just be, exactly what it sounds like. Just a podcast where we address all of our haters, all of those messy bitches who love drama so much, and we just let them know we see you, and we appreciate that you are letting us live in your head rent-free. Suck
Absolutely.
On it, you haters. I don't care. I don't care if you have a trebuchet that you're rolling up to the gates of my castle. Nothing in here for you to trebuchet. Oh, what's that? You've discovered Greek fire? I don't think so, haters.
Oh, so you're truly not worried about the haters storming the castle?
The haters can storm all they like.
Just gonna stomp around in their metal boots, making a big noise.
Yeah, march right around my castle for 7 days and blow the shofar on the seventh day. These walls don't come a tumbling down. And
I think I'd like to see.
I would love to listen. I've never claimed to not like drama myself. If the haters want to come, by all means, come, and we will be here. With the popcorn and the melted butter. And I just discovered...
And we're probably going to spill hot tea out of the window onto your battering ram
crew. We've got a big kettle full of hot tea just waiting to spill on you when you try and scale the walls of our castle.
Do you think they're going to come up through that poop chute?
I'm ready for them.
The castle poop chute?
Mm-hmm. I've been saving up the poop. It's going to come at them like the big boulder from Indiana Jones.
Oh, that makes me think about dung beetles. You know how they always get they put the poop in a big ball so they can roll it around.
To be honest, this whole podcast for the haters is just because I've been saving up the poop in a big ball and I need to get it out of here.
I mean, once you roll it down your driveway into the street, it's not your problem anymore.
Yeah, I don't even live in the city proper, right? I have a different garbage company than everybody else, which is kind of nice because every day is large item day when you live in the fancy suburb. I replaced my dishwasher and I just put that shit on the curb and it was gone the next day.
Was that because... the garbage man picked it up, or do you just have meth heads that live in your neighborhood that are like, I'm going to take this thing apart?
I'm pretty sure it was the garbage man because I set it out the day before garbage man day.
They could be one in the same. Listen, what a great job for a meth head to get.
I'm not going to discount the fact that my garbage man might be a meth head. And if he is, good for him. But I will tell you this. That guy, not one of my haters. Leave him a tip at Christmas. I always tell him, hey, brother, I'm with you. Right on. I got a sign in my yard that says science is real. People know.
Do you think that he feels condescended to when you give him the brother, or is he just like, this guy's talking to me like Hulk Hogan would?
Yeah, he's like, pretty righteous. Yeah. I think this guy, listen, if I can get my own syndicated radio show, this guy might fuck my wife on camera.
Are you saying that Bubba the Love Sponge is your garbage man?
He's more of a Bubba the Garbage Sponge.
Mm-hmm.
All right, do you?
It's a danger.
Give me an idea. Mine wasn't that great. I mean, it could be a thing. It depends on how bad the rest of the ideas we have this week are.
Mm-hmm. Well, this one was inspired by one of those Facebook posts where they say, like, you know, try to remember what month you were born in, and we're going to assign you one random item from this list, and it was demons, and my demon was Belphegor. So my podcast is called Belphegor Lore and More.
Belphegor.
And let me tell you a little.
Okay, so
I have to say, normally those things feel completely at random, but I feel a kinship with Belphegor. Okay. I really do believe he is my demon. And I'd like to tell you some things about him.
All right.
Belphegor is a demon and one of the seven princes of hell who helps people make discoveries. He seduces people by suggesting to them ingenious inventions that will make them rich. Bishop and witch hunter Peter Binsfeld believed that Belphegor tempts by means of laziness. Also, according to Peter Binsfeld's classification of demons, Belphegor is the chief demon of the deadly sin known as sloth. So I really like this guy already.
Belphegor, what, he has like a cousin he's mad at? Is that what you said? I'm going to be honest, I spaced out.
He's one of the seven princes of hell. He helps people make discoveries, seduces them by suggesting to them ingenious inventions that will make them rich. And he's also, he tempts by means of laziness and is, the chief demon associated with the deadly sin of sloth.
Now, I find it interesting that he is the demon who gives people suggested ideas for inventions, but also is the demon of sloth. Kind of seems like...
Well, he's a get-rich-quick demon. Like, he's basically the great Gazoo from the Flintstones.
Less calling people dumb-dumb. But...
I don't know. There wasn't a whole lot about his personality.
We gotta summon this demon.
Nicknames for people.
We gotta get Belphegor on the line.
We probably need to get us a big salt circle to stand in. If I learned anything, it's that demons hate salt.
They do. Yeah. It's because they're all.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they like their potatoes unsalted.
Ass. Demons, they mayonnaise too spicy for us. We don't like salt on our chicken. Belphegor lore and the more we talk about it, the more I like this idea.
I mean, we have done a Shark Tank esque podcast, and we've done religious themed things. I was thinking that maybe this could be a little bit of demon peanut butter in the Shark Tank chocolate kind of show.
Listen, that ain't chocolate in your Shark Tank. Don't kid yourself. Your sharks have a doo-doo problem.
Yeah, yeah. They're a big fish, and they're going to take up a mighty big shit.
That's why I don't even feed my sharks. Got to keep them clean. Got to keep that tank water clear for when the haters come around. You want to be like,
You're not worried at all that your sharks are going to start eating each other?
Well, that's how you make them tougher. That's why I have the strongest sharks in the world in my tank.
Yeah. Yeah, you've got like shark highlanders.
They're all sharks who can't eat other sharks because they're too damn tough. I'm going to drop a shark in there. It's gone. A matter of minutes. Just eaten up. All these sharks are just constantly circling each other. Everybody just waiting for one of them to like slip up for a second. I could drop a Bengal tiger in there. They'd eat him up right away.
Doesn't even matter if we give them floaties. It's too late.
Too little, too late. All right, I got an idea for a podcast. This one is called Burger University Graduation. Now, as you know, that many of our American comrades, the burger workers, are only getting paid pennies on the dollar for their labor, but they are forced to go through something called Burger University before they can work flipping burgers. But I thought maybe we could make it better if we held an actual graduation for everybody going through a Burger University class every week.
Okay. Do you think that it, like, they do deserve to have some sort of celebration for all the time they put in at Burger University, but will us small talking with them, won't that just boil down to, oh, what was your major at Burger University? Mm. I'm not sure if I'm going to, I might need some talking points to help me out.
Yeah. I mean, I think we could take suggestions from people on things to talk about at Burger University graduation. If there's something in specific that you want to be brought up, you know, like you're like, well, I think that I probably would have majored in fan art at Adventure Time fan art at Burger University. And then we can be like, oh, now graduating with a degree in Adventure Time fan art. Extension cord. He's back again.
Oh, man.
Could you imagine?
Do you think that extension cord has any NFTs I could possibly purchase?
Just have an NFT for your extension cord in your living room. This is the one that lets the record player go. I would just be amazed if I woke up one day and all of the extension cords in my house were gone and there was just a note that said, I finally graduated from Burger University. If you need anything.
Smell you later.
If you need anything, I'll be behind the Coca Cola Freestyle machine at Wendy's Old Fashioned Hamburgers.
No.
No! After I raised you.
Extension cord.
Oh, this is how you repay me. Your mother and I are going to starve.
Spit in my face like this? I spend all that money putting you through Burger University and you do me like this, extension cord? You're a bad boy.
I hope you like cat food for Thanksgiving because that's all me and your mother can afford anymore.
What sort of job did you envision for extension cord? You know, way back when he was just a glint in your eye, you know, before you dumped your extension cord.
Sure, shot those ropes.
The cord mother.
I really pictured extension cord going on tour with U2's Pop Mart tour.
Oh, okay.
He'd be up there plugging in that giant disco ball.
Did you think
ball.
They were going to keep running that tour back? It was just so good. They
I
were
honestly,
do it
when
every
it came
year.
Out, I thought, this is it. This is what you two will be doing for the rest of their lives.
I think that more bands should do that. Just like, well, you know, we have to do one, and we know we have to do one. Just let you know, we got nothing. We're
just,
gonna run it
know,
back. Popcorn
again.
Gonna
be disco.
Guess what? We're opening the Kmart's back up for Pop Mart 2. You can go and buy this record album at your local Kmart. They're back.
They're just progressing backwards through time since the thing where it was on your iPod and you couldn't take it off. They're like, the next album, mm-hmm. it's gonna be a censored version, and it's gonna be at Walmart, and there it is. Burger University.
What were we talking about? I lost track of. We started talking about extension cord.
It's Burger University graduation. This would be.
That's
where
right.
We do a kind of a mock graduation for everyone graduating from a Burger University.
I hope this isn't insulting, but will the graduates of Burger University be walking up to receive their diplomas to pomp and circumstance, or is there some other music that they would have play?
Well, this is tricky because I was thinking that would be like ba 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 ba, but that's just McDonald's.
That's not long enough.
It also is not long enough. Unless you want to do.
I also don't want Cheeseburger in Paradise. It's,
yeah, Cheeseburger in Paradise.
It's too on the nose.
I don't want it to be branded. I don't want it to be. Like I said, yeah, the McDonald's, blah, 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 blah. You can't have it your way. I don't know. Are there other ones?
McDonald's just over the years is. They have tons of them. There's the. Have you had your break today? Was one.
Oh, yeah.
Which that would be cool if I could have my 10-minute break at McDonald's. Just like smoking cigarettes.
Just smoking cigarettes
leaning
inside
up
of
the old McDonald's.
You just have a booth you go into, and it's like, whoosh, and then you walk out, and it's 1980s McDonald's, and they're like, "What would you like a 35-cent cheeseburger? Also, here's an ashtray for your table." You're like, "Oh my God."
Oh man, I think that's a time travel narrative that hasn't been told yet.
Time traveling, you know, cigarette smoker.
Not a lot of conflict. Just me enjoying being a dirtbag in 1983.
You're like driving down the road,
crooning along with Mac Tonight,
littering like crazy. It doesn't matter. I'm loving it.
Playing on all the old creepy McDonaldland playground equipment. Do you remember any of that stuff?
Oh, yeah. There was the Big Mac Burger Jail. Just like you climbed up a ladder to pretend to be in jail inside of a hamburger. There's actually...
I remember one of the ones... Go
ahead.
There's
actually a farm out on the south end of Louisville that has an entire intact... set of McDonaldland playground equipment. I've driven past it like, holy shit, and they have signs everywhere. It's like, this is private property. Do not come play on our McDonaldland playground.
This is for me, an old man
who's obsessed with the old fiberglass McDonaldland playground.
My friends are going to come over and we're going to play on it. This isn't for you. Instead of all the old men going to McDonald's at 5 o'clock in the morning to hang out, they all go to that guy's house.
That guy was like, "Oh, how can I get all these guys to just hang out with me?
Playground.
I know, they probably come here from the playground. All right, hang on.
There won't be any of those snooty Burger University graduates to shame me for being a 70-year-old man in the playplace.
You just made that for the Burger Townies because he got tired of people from Burger University.
They think they're so smart. Oh, he's looking down their nose at me.
All right, that was Burger University graduation. Do you got... I know you do.
Yeah,
Give me that other idea.
This other idea is a highway to the Franzia Zone, which is a mispronunciation of Franzia. And this would be a podcast in which we indulge in and also review the finest of boxed wines. Only wine that comes in cardboard, please, for me.
Now... is there what's the limit to what we could watch while we are drinking Franzia?
I think as long as we're watching wine centric films, you know, we watch a good Sideways on the highway to the Franzia Zone.
I thought that this would be at the very least Tom Cruise, Top Gun, and maybe Days of Thunder.
Maybe we could be making some cocktails with this box wine.
What if we watched Legend?
Ooh.
With Tim Curry.
Yeah, I think
Tom
Tim Curry's
Cruise
just
rides
drinking
a
blood.
Unicorn.
Yeah.
A unicorn
with a horn that wiggles.
I've never seen the film. I own it. I have a copy of it. I've never watched it.
I will watch it again. I will say that I was maybe too excited for it. I thought it was going to be more good bad movie than it was. It is not a good movie either.
Oh no. I didn't think
it's not terrible. But it's worthwhile. I haven't seen that movie since I was like 18, maybe.
Isn't it like Ridley Scott or something?
I think so.
It's probably why I own it.
Might have been his follow-up to Blade Runner. There might have been something else in between there.
Oh my god. Oh boy. Woo!
But yeah, Ridley Scott was not giving off the vibes of, I want to make fairy tale movies.
I mean, I guess at the time, was he giving off any kind of vibe? He was like...
hard sci-fi vibe.
I mean, I guess there was a sci-fi element. Maybe he was like, I gotta get out of sci-fi. Maybe I'll do some stuff with fairy tales.
Yeah, high
just
fantasy.
Just so people know, I'm not just a one-trick pony here. I'm not a one-horn unicorn.
Mm-hmm. I can do both kinds.
Both kinds of fantasy.
Sci-fi and fantasy.
Sci-fi and fantasy. Is there... there has to be like a greater umbrella term for fantasy and sci-fi, right? Fiction? Is it just fiction? Is that what I'm thinking of?
Not exactly. I think that's too broad.
Right?
Yeah, because, I mean... Philip Roth wrote fiction, but he never wrote a science fiction novel, I don't think.
I feel like fantasy is too broad. They shouldn't call it fantasy.
But yeah, all of fiction is technically a fantasy because these aren't real people. These things didn't happen.
I mean, honestly,
what are you wasting your time filling your head with this shit?
We should have one broad category called fantasy, and it involves... like elves and dragons, the future, pornography, and revenge.
Mm-hmm.
Those are all in the fantasy category. She's gonna make
this
it
is
very
a revenge
difficult.
Fantasy.
This is a dragon revenge porn fantasy.
Now one thing, like I did say high the fantasy. Dragon
posting pictures of his ex-girlfriend on 4chan.
Well, I was going to ask what is low fantasy, and I think you've hit upon it.
That is exactly what it is. It is the dragon posting his ex-girlfriend's nudes.
Now, not that I can't appreciate it. I'm not sure if I'm going to appreciate it in the way that the dragon would like me to. Hmm. Because I don't know the biology of dragons very well.
Yeah.
I think that there's a very small area you have to hit them with an arrow to pierce their heart.
That's how they have sex, too.
Oh, yeah. You got to fuck that heart hole.
You gotta find the one little spot.
Wouldn't that it's kill so it?
Difficult.
Is it like one of those things where, like, when she has the babies, it kills her, like spiders?
Female dragon stand-up comedians just keep making jokes about it. We can't find the chink in their armor.
It's tough being a dragon, you know? They want to keep that stuff secret from you.
They do. They got all that loot, too.
Mm-hmm. You ever fuck on a pile of gold?
Yes, once.
How was it?
Yeah, it was...
Was it like an elderly old man duck that you were having sex
with? Yeah, it was... That's what it was.
He kept diving down deeper, and you're like, come back here. I wasn't done with you. Swim back up here. I can't do
Swim
that.
Swim back up here, Scrooge. I'm going to suck that corkscrew dick. Highway to the Franzia Zone. I feel like we might have strayed a little bit from the original idea there.
Well, that's fine because the original idea is that we have to drink boxed wine. So I'd imagine that there would be a lot of stray thoughts in that episode.
Yeah, I mean maybe that's what we do. If we go with this idea, it's you and me and Daniel reunite to do another drunken movie commentary, and we pick one of the early films of Tom Cruise. So okay. It has to be Risky Business, Legend.
Mm. What's that one where he's a football player and a high school football player?
Oof. I don't know.
I gotta look that up real quick. We really like that. That is what it is. That is what this podcast idea is. So. We really need to know what we're working with, Cruise style. Do you think that Tom's going to be mad that he's not in our version of Saturday Night Live, that we went with extension cord instead of Tom?
I think he'll understand. He seems like, you know, did you hear that leaked audio of him screaming at people on the set of the Mission Impossible or whatever about the COVID-19 and how he's keeping Hollywood afloat? Didn't hear him say a word about extension cord letting him down.
He knows. Well, that's because extension cord is religious about wearing that mask.
That's right.
Sleeps in that mask.
Extension cord has never missed a payment to the Church of Scientology.
Okay, I'm going to give you every Tom Cruise movie up until... We'll go for a while. Endless Love is his first movie.
Ooh.
Then you got Taps, The Outsiders, Losing It, Risky Business, mm-hmm. All the Right Moves. That's the football one I was trying to think of. Legend, Top Gun, Color of Money, Cocktail. Next one's Rain Man. I feel like Cocktail and Before is what we're looking at.
Yeah, those are all... Ooh, maybe Cocktail. Feels like that's the right one. If you're going to get drunk and watch a movie, Cocktail would be the one to do.
Mm-hmm. But we can bandy that about. You know, there's a lot of crews to go around.
There's plenty, folks. Just spread him around.
Mm-hmm.
Like real thin. Like Vegemite.
Yeah, a little bit of Tom Cruise goes a little
goes a long way with mm-hmm. with Tommy C.
Yeah, you ever get a big old clump of Tommy C and watch your face go? It goes.
Oh,
that's too much Cruise. It's a Cruise clump.
Folks, do it in the mirror. Get yourself about a teaspoon of Tom Cruise. Just put it on your tongue and then watch your face react in the mirror. Mm-hmm. Hashtag Tom Cruise challenge. Do a selfie on TikTok. You tasting just a teaspoon of Tom Cruise and then face reacting to it.
What do you think is harder to do? Hashtag the Tom Cruise challenge or the cinnamon challenge?
Oh, Tom Cruise challenge all the way. He's jumping up and down, claiming he's in love.
All right, not anymore. I think that part of Tom's life is over. I think he has said no mas.
Folks, that sucks.
Thrice bitten, like 50 times shy now. He's not taking no dates.
All right, let's head to the hotline.
Okay.
Folks, if you have an idea for a podcast, please let us know. You can reach out to us at our podcast hotline. That's 702-PODCASP. That's the phone number to call. Or you can send us an email at wedonthaveapodcastyet. Tell us what you think would be a good podcast for us to do. Ben writes, Netflix and Chili's. A podcast where you pair Chili's menu offerings with Netflix original series.
Ooh.
Now,
they actually should pair together. They're both approximations of what you actually want.
This is embarrassing because I feel like this is a thing that could exist in real life. But I'm like, we could also do this. Here's what I propose. You look up the Chili's menu, and I will look up a list of Netflix originals, and then we can we'll do like a ping pong back and forth.
Okay. Oh man, there's a lot of shit on here. Okay, what would you pair with the Boss Burger? The burger all other burgers report to. Smoked brisket, tender rib meat, jalapeno cheddar smoked sausage, bacon, and cheddar with lettuce, tomato, house barbecue, and ranch. We dare you.
I would pair that with mink. The famous Herman J. Mankiewicz film directed by David Fincher and starring Gary Oldman. Who else? Who else but that could be the Boss Burger?
Okay, well, here we've got the spicy shrimp tacos. Three spicy chili lime shrimp tacos and flour tortillas with pico, avocado, cilantro, coleslaw, queso fresco. Served with Mexican rice and black beans.
Now for that one. I'd have to go with Marriage Story.
Okay.
We got the spiciness of Adam Driver mixed with the creaminess of Scarlett Johansson, and everything is at odds in this delicious spicy shrimp taco.
Okay.
Well, will they stay together or no?
I mean, you'll have to tune in and dig in to find out.
Mm-hmm.
Do you want to do a reverse pairing? Do you want to give me a film and I'll...
All right, I got one. Bright. Okay.
Bite?
Bite?
Is that what you said?
Oh, no, sorry. I said bright.
Bright. Okay, this is the Will Smith high fantasy cop buddy film where he's buddies with an orc. Okay.
That's right. That's right.
All right. Let me see if they have anything tartar. I think that orcs like to eat their food raw. Let's see. No, fuck that. I'm going off the kids menu for this one. Bright sucks. How about a Pepper Pals cheeseburger bites? Cheeseburger bites made with all natural beef and served with a choice of side and a drink. That's right. It's just a disc of beef with a slice of cheese on it. It's on a King's Hawaiian. Fuck you, Bright.
Now
you got the Chili's punishment. You're sitting at the kids' table with the orcs.
Is that fair?
I mean, isn't that what Bright's about? Is racism against orcs?
I don't know. I've never seen it.
I haven't either. I heard it was bad.
All I know about Bright is that was the movie that Max Landis tweeted. I've come to slowly realize that Bright, my new script, if made well, could potentially be my Star Wars. And it feels crazy.
Oh, man.
And then he made Bad Boys, but in Middle Earth.
Yeah. Well, isn't it South Central Los Angeles, but just a version of it that has fairies and orcs and other.
I believe that the plot is that someone finds a magic wand and that's, they're like, oh, it's no, WMD. It's like a nuclear bomb.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, Max Landis is just a rich kid. He didn't know any better. Let's not pick on him.
It's fine that he's never going to have a Star Wars. Not everybody gets a Star Wars.
Max, if you're out there, if you're listening, as long as you don't kill a couple of non-union actors with a helicopter, I think you're doing all right.
Oh, God.
Woo!
Oof, that was spicy. Maybe I should have paired it with fuck me. I'm on the kids menu. There's nothing spicy on there. How about I'm gonna give that the honey chipotle crispers and waffles. Crispers on top of Belgian waffles, topped with bacon, jalapenos, ancho chili ranch, and served with fries and honey chipotle sauce.
Wait, so crispers, just to be clear.
They appear like to be fingers? The fingers of a chicken, yes.
The fingers of a chicken. Folks, I'm going to have to give that a Hubie Halloween. Adam Sandler, back to what he does best, playing a man with an extra chromosome.
Yeah. That vomits on command, I think.
Is that... I'll be honest, I watched that movie twice. Couldn't tell you anything about that movie.
I have not watched it at all, but I think that I heard that it had a big vomit scene. So,
there might have been.
Throwing his chilies up.
Honestly, yeah. I watched it with my children, and then I watched it again with my children, and it didn't stick the second time either, so...
It's
either going to be that or my octopus teacher.
Octopus teacher. I'm not familiar with that at all, but I am on the prowl for some calamari now. Where are you at?
My octopus teacher, which I think what I have not seen that either, but what I've read is that apparently it's about a man who develops a parasexual relationship with an octopus.
Ooh, I mean, all of those arms/legs, and they're all They got those suction cups. I'd imagine there's some good stuff an octopus could do for you.
Hmm. Yeah.
And you know, maybe we shouldn't eat the octopus, actually, you know, masticate and swallow it whole. Let's get something that we can both enjoy, and who doesn't like ribs? So let's feed that octopus teacher the mix and match ribs. Looks like you get some corn with it. I don't know why it's called mix and match. It looks like Mexican street corn, French fries.
They got a beak, right? They have a little beak. They can probably handle corn on the cob.
Okay, all right. That was rude of me. You think they like coleslaw?
Yeah.
All right. I don't know. They aren't that big. We'll get them the half order of the house barbecue ribs. Get some coleslaw and fries.
All right. Let's head to the Podtron.
Okay.
What do you say?
Let's do it.
All right, folks. If you don't know, the Podtron 4500 is an artificial intelligence that we gave the names of every popular podcast on the Apple podcast charts. And then it tried to synthesize new names for podcasts that it thinks could be as successful. Podcasts like... Take it away, AJ.
Biggerverse.
So this is all one word, Biggerverse?
It is Bigger-verse.
Oh, there's a hyphen in there.
Yeah. Which
Biggerverse.
I guess it could go kind of Spider-verse, and it's just a universe where everything's a little bit bigger than it was before. And boy, howdy, are the podcasts just... packed to the gills. These are some big ass podcasts.
Just like, wait a minute. This podcast used to be an hour long. Now it's an hour 15. And my pants are falling down. What is this? I can't finish this hoagie. Am I living in the Biggerverse?
Oh, man. I wish I could live in the Biggerverse.
There's some things, right?
Do you think I'd have to get like a double-edged
sword?
Car?
Everything is bigger. It's like when everyone's special, no one is. You look, your pants are like all loosey-goosey around your waist, and you hold them out, and you look down, you see your penis and balls, and you go, "Hachi machi, all right." And then you walk, you cinch up your loose. Waistband on your pants, and you strut out into the world like, now I know what's up. And then you meet up with a lady and you're like, hey, you want to go back to my place and see about the Biggerverse? And then she takes off her pants and it's like, hello.
Yeah.
Everything's bigger in the Biggerverse.
Mm-hmm. Can you imagine if you were in a sack race in the Biggerverse? I'm having enough trouble holding these pants up, and now you want me to get in a burlap sack? My arms can't even reach the ends of it.
The burlap sack is so big that now the whole race is inside of the burlap sack.
Oh. You did a twist on me.
Man, I feel like I would like to know when the last burlap sack race was. It feels like that's not a thing that happens anymore, right?
Do it all the time.
Burlap.
I'm doing time trials, though. I time myself.
You're just training and hoping this will be the year they bring the sack race back to the Olympics.
I'm going to be ready. Win gold for America.
Sack race champion. The Biggerverse.
Mm-hmm. There anything that's speaking to you from that list?
Yeah. I like this one called The Ben Show.
The Ben Show.
The Ben Show.
Now this is B-E-N, or are you saying B-E-N-D? Ben. Okay.
No, Ben. Yeah, the name Ben. And this would be, I like this one because it requires someone named Ben to be in charge. So we could just... hand it off to Ben for a week.
Okay. I do like that. Are we going to vet the Bens? I don't want to get... Ben Stein can't be on this show.
Ben Stein. I mean, honestly, if he wanted to just go crazy about creationism for a week on our on our Patreon, I'd let
that would
him
be,
do
that
it.
Would be great, actually.
Be like, well, when I was friends with Richard Nixon, well, now that I made him sound like Al Gore.
He kind of does. Yeah, were you going to talk about how they like to fuck octopuses together?
Me and Al Gore like to fuck an octopus. We got the idea from James Bond when he fucked a lady named Octopussy, and we said, we can't fuck a lady, but maybe if we just fuck the octopus, that would be cool. Anyways, welcome to the Ben Show. Today we will be talking about fucking an octopus. I'm sorry, what? what was your question?
Do you think that Ben Al Gore Stein frequently gets made fun of because he talks like a television star, Mr. Ed?
That's the thing. He isn't even attracted to octopuses, but they keep putting that peanut butter on his gums. Just tricks him into it. And that's the same defense that Jared Fogle should have used for
he was ordering peanut butter sandwiches from Subway.
I just ordered a peanut butter submarine. And they made me say all that stuff about children.
Yeah. And people like would just forget about it because they'd be their minds would be blown. I just considered a
I can't
peanut butter
a
and jelly
fat man could talk. All right, do you have another idea for a podcast?
Yeah, this one is called King Much Happening.
King, is that a colon that I heard?
No, that was more my addition. It's King Much Happening.
King Much Happening.
I was just trying to parse it and think about what it is. I mean, it sort of seems like it could be a podcast in which one of us gets to be the king and the other one gets to be the messenger. And we have to convince the king that even though this is very bad news, that maybe don't cut my head off.
One of us is the king and the other one is the messenger bringing messages. My lord, my liege, your highness, we have news from the Western Front. It appears that the men have all got trench dick.
Blech.
Yes, I know this ruins your Christmas plan to tickle all the men's penises. I know you looked forward to raising their spirits as this horrible war drags on. And I know that you've already written in your journals that you were going to tickle all of the men's penises.
That is the deal. It's like, you get to be king, but one day out of the year, you're going to tickle all these dicks.
I think that would probably... Listen, if you want to be president, you got to agree to be executed on the last day of your presidency. And if you want to be king, you got to tickle every soldier's dick. Mm-hmm. And then we'll see how many soldiers you want to have in your kingdom. This wouldn't work. We just get a gay warmonger king. I've already figured out the problem with our plan.
There's always
it assumes
problem.
That everyone is homophobic and not just me.
But that could be really good because it could be a different kind of king each time. We could more or less be proposing a new style of monarchy every time and then finding the flaws within it.
Yeah.
Because all of your kingly actions, there's always much more happening than what you have planned.
It's like a Kobayashi Maru type situation where one of us is always the king and the other one is just coming at us with impossible situations to figure out. My lord, they're canceling Carol Burnett for being too woke.
Give her a sleeping pill and a new mid-season replacement show with Peter Krause and Jeremy Piven.
Fuck, I'd watch that.
I would watch it now more than I would have when they actually did it.
Wait, was there a show with Peter Krause and Jeremy Piven?
And Carol Burnett from somewhere in between.
Oh, wait, we talked about
this. Yeah, we talked about this. It was somewhere between like 1987 and 1990.
All right, here's my second idea from the Podtron. This one is called This is Actually Happy House with Dr. Deep Dive.
Now, is Happy House like Happy Family, the meal that I get at the Chinese food restaurant?
Now, Happy Family. I am familiar with Happy Family. There is, okay, so I just Googled Happy House. And it is a song by Susie and the Banshees. So that could be it. It could be us being insufferable hipsters who call ourselves Dr. Deep Dive. And we just talk about this lesser known proto-punk. Wait, would this be
just one song though? Normally when people do a deep dive, they're like, I'm casting my net wide, and we're like, no, our net is effectively a spear that is going to stab this one
a
song.
Podcast, we are Dr. Deep Dive, and this podcast just covers one song by Susie and the Banshees.
It's our great white whale.
This is Happy House.
And Happy House is the name of our boat as well, because, and the name of the whale.
The actual title of the podcast is This is Actually Happy House. So maybe we're arguing that the Happy House by Susie and the Banshees is not underground enough. And there is another song called Happy House that's lesser known, and we're like, this is actually Happy House.
Yeah, when
by Dr. Deep Dive.
House, you need to be talking about X, which is, I'm not talking about the band X. I'm saying that I don't know yet because the deep dive hasn't happened.
Yeah, okay, here's, I'm looking up another Happy House. Now this is Happy House. Wait, could you hear that? Ah, fuck. Ah, son of a bitch. I screwed it up. Well, I'll add it in post.
Whoa, what a cool song. Now, that is actually Happy House. I mean, the other house was happy some of the times, but then there were some times I just wanted to get out of there.
That was just our house. I'll never leave our street.
I'd probably never leave our house.
It's in the middle of the street.
It's a terrible.
You would have to leave the house when a Jeep Compass barreled through the dining room because our house is in the middle of our street.
But isn't my room upstairs?
I'm just gonna. Oh, and yeah. Also, I'm gonna tuck I have in. Fucking
squatter's rights. You got to go through proper channels to get rid of me, baby.
You're just up there clinging for dear life to your mattress. There's a Dollar General semi truck just barrels through on 18 wheels.
It's cool. I've got one of those zip lines like Kevin from Home Alone down to my treehouse.
Hey, Dollar General, come and get me, you sons of bitches.
And then when I get over there, I'll listen to our treehouse in the middle of our tree.
You horse's ass. All right, here are our podcast ideas this week. We have a podcast for all the haters, Belphegor Lore and More, Burger University Graduation, Highway to the Franzia Zone, Netflix and Chili's, Biggerverse, The Ben Show, King Much Happening, and this is actually Happy House with Dr. Deep Dive.
Okay, I think we kind of decided that we were going to watch the Tom Cruise movies.
All right. Highway to the Franzia Zone.
Which also, if I mean, I don't mind saying some bad things about the haters, and I also wouldn't mind ordering some chilies in for this event. So.
Okay, so let's do a three-way podcast here. We're going to watch. Wait, what was the Tom Cruise movie we agreed on?
I think Cocktail.
Cocktail. We're gonna watch Cocktail.
We could do Legend too. You know, maybe you're surprised. Legend.
We'll see. And we will be ordering chilies to go.
Mm-hmm.
And we will be talking shit on the haters. And I guess Franzia will also be, we'll be drinking boxed wine. So, there you go.
It will be a classy affair.
Highway to the Franzia Zone. A Netflix and Chili's podcast for all the haters. That's the title. All right, folks, if you want to hear that, head over to patreon.com/we don't have a podcast yet. That's our Patreon. If you sign up as a supporter, you will get access to every Friday's episode along with the entire back catalog in the We Don't Have a Podcast Yet vault. If you like the show that isn't a show, you'll like the show that is a show even more, folks. And that's the We Don't Have a Podcast Yet guarantee. On behalf of myself and my co-host.
Hello.
Good night.
Goodbye.
With Chester Cathedral.